From the house you're living in, to the school you went to, what is everything made of? Cement. But have you ever wondered how cement is made? And what makes cement so strong? We're going to show you exactly how cement is made. From crushing and grinding all the materials to packaging it. You're going to want to stick till the end, because we're going to let you in on some of the industry's biggest secrets about cement. What are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button, and let's get down into some construction. Nowadays, cement is employed extensively in the building of different technical constructions all around the world. It is unmatched in production and applications, and has established itself as one of the most advanced technical materials of the modern era. Although cement can be used neat, that is, without any other ingredients as grouting materials, its typical application is in mortar and concrete, where it is combined with aggregate, an inert substance, to create a powerful binding medium. Cement requires the mining of a variety of minerals. This industry requires bulky and heavy raw materials. Coal and electric power are needed apart from rail transport. The majority of it is made up of gypsum, clay, and limestone, which contains the mineral calcite. According to the U.S. Geological Survey, geologically extensive and fortunately abundant limestone is a common raw material used in cement. The U.S. Geological Survey's 2015 Cement Mineral Commodity Summary shows that domestic cement output has been gradually rising from 66.4 million tons in 2010 to around 80.5 million tons in 2014. Portland cement was produced domestically. About $8.9 billion worth of cement was sold altogether, the majority of which was utilized to produce concrete valued at an estimated $48 billion. Concrete is used in most building projects in one way or another. There are more than 20 types of cement used to make various specialty concrete. However, the most common is Portland cement. Cement manufacturing is a complex process that begins with mining and then grinding raw materials that include limestone and clay to a fine powder called raw meal, which is then heated to a sintering temperature as high as 1450 degrees Celsius in a cement kiln. In this process, the chemical bonds of the raw materials are broken down and then they are recombined into new compounds. The result is called clinker, which are rounded nodules between 1 mm and 25 mm across. The clinker is ground to a fine powder in a cement mill and mixed with gypsum to create cement. The powdered cement is then mixed with water and aggregates to form concrete that is used in construction. Although more than 20 different types of cement are utilized to manufacture different kinds of specialized concrete, such a tiresome process. The composition of the raw materials determines the clinker quality, which must be regularly checked to guarantee cement quality. For instance, too much lime might have unfavorable effects like volume expansion, longer setting times, or decreased strength. To guarantee process control at every stage of the cement manufacturing process, including clinker generation, a number of online and laboratory technologies can be used. Research Lab Cement QC Laboratories employ X-ray fluorescence, XRF devices, to identify major and minor oxides in cement, clinker, and raw materials like bauxite, sand, and limestone. To find out why XRF is the preferred method for elemental analysis in the cement industry, read Analysis of Clinker and Cement with Thermoscientific, ARL Optik IMS DXERF, Sequential Spectrometer. Chemical phase analysis is achieved using combination X-ray fluorescence, XERF, and X-ray diffraction, XRD systems, providing a more thorough characterization of the material. Consistent clinker quality is guaranteed by clinker phase analysis. Such equipment can be equipped with several XRF monochromators for the measurement of key oxides and a compact diffraction XRD system that can measure quartz in the phases of clinker, free lime, calcium oxide, and raw meal. The second largest producer of premium cement in the world is India. There are around 365 minor cement factories and 183 large cement mills in India. Currently, 40 companies around the country are involved in the sector. Approximately 20,000 workers are employed in the cement industry's downstream industries for every million tons of cement produced. Coal is used in the cement industry in India since it is widely available, while natural gas and oil are in short supply. These days, coal with a high ash percentage and a variety of properties is required by the Indian cement industry. To address this issue, Research has been done on the function of coal in the production of cement, as well as potential enhancements to coal consistency and quality. In Porbandar, Gujarat, the nation's first cement company with a 10,000-ton capacity began operations in 1914. The world's greenest and most energy-efficient cement mills nowadays are found in India. Till the end, cement cannot be replaced, and the increasing production of cement is the result of modernization spreading widely and the employment of cutting-edge technologies.